President Trump's first trip abroad placed him at the Vatican today, marking Mr. Trump's first meeting with the leader of the Catholic Church. Special correspondent Malcolm Brabant is in Rome for us tonight, and he has this report.
It was a meeting of two men with a difficult history. After a public greeting, President Trump and Pope Francis spoke privately for half an hour. Later, there were introductions all around and group pictures with Mr. Trump smiling broadly and the pontiff stone-faced. Just a little over a year ago, they clashed publicly. The Pope took on the Trump campaign pledge to build a wall along the U.S.-Mexico border.
A person who only thinks about building walls, wherever they may be, and not building bridges, is not a Christian.
But the candidate answered with a dig of his own.
For a religious leader, to question a person's faith is disgraceful.
Today, instead of barbs, they exchanged gifts. Mr. Trump presented the Pope with a first edition set of Martin Luther King Jr.'s works. Francis offered his three main teaching documents and an olive branch medal. Later, after touring the Sistine Chapel and St. Peter's Basilica, the president offered a new assessment of the Pope.
He is something. He is really good. We had a fantastic meeting and we had a fantastic tour. It was really beautiful.
President Trump's take on his meeting with Pope Francis differs greatly from the interpretation of veteran Vatican analysts. They believe that the president was exaggerating. The Vatican issued an unusually brief statement about the discussions.
They qualified the meeting as cordial, which means that the meeting was not a cold one, but a cordial one. But in any case, it was not a warm meeting.
Long-term Vatican watcher Ricardo Cristiano says he doubts there was any meeting of minds.
I think it was an opportunity to meet, but also the impression is that they understood they have a different perspective.
Analyst Robert Mickens was far more upbeat. He says it was a success for the Vatican.
Pope Francis is always very gracious. He likes to build bridges of encounter. It's very, very important to get the superpower online with the soft power of the Holy See.
The president also met with the Vatican's Secretary of State, who encouraged continued U.S. participation in the Paris Climate Agreement. Secretary of State Rex Tillerson gave his own appraisal on the flight from Rome to Brussels.
Well, we had a good exchange on, you know, the difficulty of balancing, addressing climate change, responses to climate change, and ensuring that you still have a thriving economy.
The president arrived in Brussels this evening for meetings with European Union and NATO officials and was greeted by the Belgian Prime Minister and royal family. Thousands of demonstrators also turned out, protesting the president's immigration and environmental policies. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Malcolm Brabant in Rome.